Okay, so what is up? Today we're going to be talking about self-portraits and how I shoot them. Okay, I never use my phone to do anything, but I just put a hoodie on. I'm just doing these to kind of help promote Lord Shot hoodies, and I'm taking the photos in these because I want this cool look. But anyways, I'm going to start off with the gear on what I use to take my self-portraits. So right now I'm using a Sony a6500 for the camera. Then I'm also using this light that I got on Amazon for like, I don't even remember how much it was. I think it was like $50 for two of them. And then I'm using this tripod that I literally got from Walmart. So most of the stuff that you guys see on my Instagram, if you're not following it, it's at MontelFish. It's stuff that I've personally taken, or usually it's just when it's behind this like white wall and different stuff like that. I have a lot of friends take my stuff, but a lot of stuff I do take myself, and I edit all my stuff anyway. So this is kind of a how I take myself portrait tutorial. It's very simple, very straightforward. But if you do only have an iPhone or you don't have the same camera as me, just apply these same techniques and everything should go great. So right now I have my camera set up in portrait mode because that's what I know I'm gonna wanna take. I have a 30 mil lens on right now, which gives me, it's more of like a closer lens, which makes the shots more tight. And then I'm gonna show you guys my settings. I'm always shooting mainly at around 1.4 because it gives me the blurriest background. It gives me just the most amount of bokeh or depth of field that I want. Even in these close-up photos where there's nothing really going on in the background, I still get some depth of field. And then I just set myself timer on 2 seconds and I just take a bunch of photos until I get something that I like. So I'm just gonna do that now. So after that, I just throw the pictures into Lightroom, but I kind of want to give you guys a bit of background on why I chose even what I'm wearing and how that affects the photo. And so first off, I'm shooting on a plain white background, which looks sick for just the style of photography that I like to do, especially close-up face stuff where you don't want too much stuff distracting in the background, but it sets the white balance good. It just gives you a good base. Next, the complementary colors are like huge when you're trying to take photos and when you're trying to get stuff that's just good. So I know that this orange beanie is gonna stick out because teal and orange are like two complementary colors that are really good for when you're color grading stuff. So a lot of my stuff, when you look at my photos on Instagram, you'll just see that the colors are they just look well together in the photos and everything like that. And so I think about that when I'm picking out my outfit and what I'm gonna wear in the photos. A gray hoodie is always pretty good because it's a neutral color. It won't get in the way of when you're color grading it, when you're in Lightroom, when you're messing around with the colors, it won't get in the way. If I was to wear a bright yellow shirt, that would mess things up. So I always try to stick with some more neutral colors. I always try to stick with some more just, or a color that I know that's gonna look good, like orange. And this just comes with repetition. So repeat, and then you just go from there. But right now I'm gonna hop into Lightroom and edit some photos. Okay guys, so this is pretty much the end of the video, but right now I'm just editing the photos. I'm gonna show you guys what it looks like right now, but if you did like this video, like, comment, subscribe, become a part of the fam. For this one, like I said, I'm going for more of a teal and orange kind of look. So I'm adding this preset that I already have on here, and it kind of just gives it a more of like a filmic look. So I'm going to show you guys the photos now, but thank you guys for watching this tutorial, and I'll see you on the next one. Peace out.